Morning. So it's 3 a.m. Alarm just went off and we are getting ready to go to the airport. It's so cold. I'm about to make breakfast. Everyone wants food at 3 a.m. It's a long journey ahead of us. This is how I normally start my morning stuff. So yeah. And we put the last bit of stuff in our bag that we washed last night. So that's what I'm doing right now. And toothpaste. We forgot to pack toothpaste. Alright. Good morning. It's travel day. Welcome. We're going to Jamaica for a month. Isn't that crazy? Okay, so I made grits and tuna. Traditionally baking my breakfast because it's the last time we're gonna have it for a while because we are gonna be having lots of Jamaican breakfast. Grits and tuna for the boys and avocado toast with tomato for me because I don't eat tuna. Yeah, so grits, tuna, and avocado. The voice. Morning, Krishna. Come say morning. Come tell everyone your morning. The grits are so good. Oh my god, it's green coffee.
Hello.
Are you excited? Where are we going? Tell everyone where we're going.
Miami.
No, we're in Miami. Where are we going? Being shy. Alright, so we're in Miami and we're going to Jamaica. It is August 4th at around 3:30 a.m. And yeah, the Bahamas is currently in a full lockdown. And we're just like, plus we gotta go visit my granddad. He had a stroke. He's not doing well. So hence the reason for the trip. And we're going for a month because yeah, it's summertime and there's not much to do in the Bahamas, so we're getting into that. Are you excited? Are you excited? Should I go?
I'm not excited about that thing.
That's okay.
Let me go hiking.
Go hiking. You want to go hiking in the mountains?
I mean, I don't want to go hiking when not for 6 hours, you say?
Yeah, I know. It takes a really long time. Alright, that's okay. Alright. See you guys. I'm gonna go get ready.
So I've diffused my hair and I washed it. And a little bit of the Bahamas Organics. And we are rocking a big curly fro today.
I'm so excited.
I love with my curls. These are kind of stretch out a little bit. Yeah. So now I'm gonna enjoy my avocado toast. Because it's important to have a great breakfast before you travel. Especially right now when there's like not a lot of places open, you know, the coronavirus, all that kind of stuff. Like you don't really want to eat in the airport. So here's the breakfast. The boys already ate while I was in the shower, so I do not want to see that. But we're having breakfast at my grandma's house when we get there. I'm so excited. Oh god. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go get my oh my god. That was like tomato guts all up in my fish. Mm. It's so bad.
So we're at the airport and I'm waiting on my bag because they have to check. I think it's because of the gimbal in my bag. However, we're stuck in security, trying to figure it out. Security was okay. TSA was pretty bad. Checking was easy. We did it outside at the Fort Lauderdale Airport and we're good. We sanitized and I just tell them to do a backup while we good. So it's now 6:30, well 6:25 really, and we're boarding.
Out in the street, they call it murder.
Welcome to Jamrock, camp where the thugs and camp at. £2 within a van back. It in a your handbag, your knapsack, it in a your backpack. The smell of the your girlfriend contact. Some boy not know this. Them only come around like tourists on the beach with a few club sodas. Bedtime stories and pose like them name Chuck.
Okay guys, so you see us coming through the airport and all of that. Let me tell you what happened when we got here in Jamaica. So our plane landed and Ministry of Health came on the PA system when you know, when the plane reached to the door and they announced and making was the door open. Well, the Ministry of Health came and they let us know, welcome to Jamaica, and that we'll be doing COVID screenings and all that kind of stuff. Now bear in mind, we took COVID tests before we came. We also applied on visitjamaica.com or something like that for authorization to enter the country. That was really easy. I got mine back in 5 seconds. Like I applied for everyone at the same time. We got it back like instantly. Like the minute I pressed send, it was in my email. So anyway, we got that. We have our negative test. And now we come off the plane. There's a health official in like PPE. Except gloves, which bothered me, handing out pieces of paper for us to write our temperature on. Sir, why are you not wearing gloves? So I had to sanitize my hand after I got that from him. And we came off the plane in, we didn't come off in rows. We just, everybody stood up and like tried to like, you know, be cumbersome and, you know, this guy ran past ahead, which I think is so silly. I'd be like, why are you brushing? Why are you touching people to push ahead? Like, it's so silly. Anyway, we get off. We got the paper. On the paper, you have to write your temperature. They tell you to write your name and your temperature on there. There's a few lines for, like what the health official is going to fill out. So, anyway, we do that. We got out and we reached in the hallway. In the hallway, there are little markers where you're supposed to stand. We all line up, basically. I was with my son, so definitely we're in like the disabled and people with children line. Sorry. So when we were there, we're waiting. They have JDF officers are there in full gear, PPE, gloves, like over their head, mask, everything, right? So there's one nurse for this whole flight going around taking people's temperature. Here's the thing that bothered me. The guy behind us in the wheelchair, with the wheelchair woman, every time I move up, he move up behind me. I'd be like, sir, you're not 6 feet behind me. Why are you backing up? Why are you staying to your marker? Like, he kept pushing her closer. I was like, what's happening? Anyway, whatever. We get to the front, we waited. The wait was like about 20 minutes to get to the table. Now, there was about 5 persons doing interview. Of course, I take the people in wheelchair and stuff first, but me with my child had to wait. But anyway, after 20 minutes, we finally got to the table and get to talk to the lady, the nurse, who explained to us everything that's happening, that we have to sign a COVID quarantine agreement and all that kind of stuff. So, yes, I am currently in quarantine. We're allowed to leave for food or if you go anywhere, you know, you can't go anywhere that's crowded or whatever. So yeah, what else we did? So anyway, she asked us a bunch of questions, like, have I been exposed, have I ever had measles, mumps, all them stuff, you know, chickenpox, whatever. She asked if you had like pre-existing conditions, where you're staying, a number, a local number, all that kind of stuff. I gave her information. Now she has to fill this out individually for each person. So it's like me, my person, my son. It's like, you know, it's like three different forms. It's a lot. So it took some time. We were at her table for like maybe 15-20 minutes again. So anyway, we finally come out. We go through immigration. We had filled out our immigration form online, which you can, and you can let them know, and they could just go ahead and pull it up. But the immigration officer was being a real, so he didn't, I mean, yeah. So anyway, he just, and I had made sure to fill out the paper forms just in case, because I was like, I really need to know drama, because these people have an attitude and I ain't into that. So anyway, we go through immigration, they stamp us, and then when you come out to go get your bags, they have all your bags grouped together and lined up, you know what I mean? Like, and like everybody have on gear and stuff or whatever. So anyway, they have our bags. So, but I thought that was it. No, that is not it. They have these chairs right outside the door. You have to sit there, and then you have to download the app. Now, I was a smart cookie. I had the app downloaded on my phone before I got to Jamaica. However, here's the thing. This is where the travel authorization form comes in. There is a code on there. There's a reference number or immigration card code or something. I can't remember what it means. That you have to enter in the app to activate your thing. So apparently all your information is already pre-stored in there. So anyway, after I download the app, put in the, I mean, you know, putting my information in the app, activated or whatever, you have to do a check-in right there. So just how I'm doing a video log right now, it's the same thing you have to do with their app. Now, let me tell you, these people are very thorough, okay? Very thorough. There were so many questions. There was just so much information that they needed, and they covered all their bases. I was impressed. I felt safe. I felt secure. I didn't feel like I was going to get COVID, like, I feel good. So anyway, I did that. Did my check-in. The app works flawlessly. I have no issues. It shows you all the parishes. It shows you how many cases per parish, how many deaths per parish, and all that kind of stuff, which is great. There's like a constant update of the app. Now, these check-ins are annoying as hell. The first day, I had like 8 check-ins. The second day, I had a bunch. So like, as it come down to like, you know, the like day 10 and stuff, you know, I had like 2 days where I had no check-ins at all. And in my check-in, I have to say a number. They send you a code and you have to say the code in the video. So you have to be like, hey, 2365, I'm feeling okay. You know, they ask you for your temperature. They ask you, are you feeling any symptoms? And then they ask you to say the code in the video. And then you click submit. And once you submit, you're good to go. And that's it. I've been here, I've been able to go to the food store, do a little small stuff, that didn't include a bunch of people. I haven't been out much. I've been, you know, social distancing when I do go out, you know, sanitize, I keep track of my temperature, all that kind of stuff. And like I said, I had a negative COVID test when we came, and we all feel great. I'm pretty sure we're fine, but you know, they say you could have been exposed on a plane or whatever, so that's what that's for. And yeah, so stay tuned, because we're here for a month and we're gonna be doing lots of stuff as soon as we're out and about, you know, on an adventure. So stay tuned. This is gonna be a series, I promise. It's gonna be a couple of vlogs. Now, how soon are you gonna get it? I know, but you get it, okay? You get it. I'm gonna give you like a nice guide on like all the good stuff to do in Jamaica. Alright, thanks for watching. Make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe, okay? Because I want to see you very soon. Bye, guys.